In the last video, we were discussing about translation exposure on current rate method as well as monetary and non-monetary method. We'll move to the one more problem on the same area, that is translation exposure. The problem has been displayed on the screen. Just read out the problem. AV Limited is the Indian affiliated to US sports manufacturing. AV Limited manufactures items which are sold primarily in the US and Europe. AV's balance sheet in thousands of rupees as on 31st March is as follows. They have given assets as well as liabilities. Exchange rates for translating the balance sheet into US dollar are, first one what they are given is rupees 35 per dollar, historic exchange rates, at which plant and equipment, long term loan and common stocks were acquired. So three things has been acquired historical rate. One is basically plant and equipment, then followed by long term loan, then lastly common stock. So these are things which has been acquired at a historical price. And second point, what it says is rupee 40 per dollar March 31st exchange date. This was also the rate at which inventory acquired. Inventory is acquired at the rate of 40. Okay. Then third one, what there means, rupees 42 per dollar April 1st exchange rate after devaluation of 20%. Assuming no change in balance sheet accounts between 31st March and 1st April, calculate the accounting gain or loss by the current rate method and monetary and non-monetary method. Explain accounting loss in terms of change in the value of exposed assets. These are the information what they are given. Okay, as per the information what they are given, basically plant and equipment, long term loan and capital assets, they acquired at a historical price, and inventory acquired at the rate of rupee 40 per dollar, and today exchange rate is rupee 42 per dollar. Okay, this is the information what they are given. So if you first talk about the current rate method, I'm talking only current rate method. I'm expecting you to solve the monetary and non-monetary method. In case of current rate method, all the items should be recorded at a historical rate, except all the items should be recorded basically at a current rate method. Okay, except your capital. Okay, so we have to have the two balance sheets here. That's on 31st March as well as on, I'm writing current rate method. One is 31st March and second is 1st April. Okay, on 31st March, what is the value? On 31st March, if you calculate the, if you check the value, I'll write here 40 rupees per dollar, and this also will write 40 because we are writing a current rate method. Okay, so always capital, and in case of current rate method, capital and retained earnings should be recorded at a historical price. Okay, now what it means, 1 rupee is equal to, I'll write here for your information, 1 rupee is equal to $40. Okay, so now how much rupee we have? We have 6000. 6000 is equal to how much? If you cross multiply 6000 to 40, if you divide, that is they mentioned in terms of dollars. They are given, let me check it out whether they are in dollars or in rupees. In terms of rupees, they are given. Okay, so in terms of rupees, they are given. Now we have to convert to dollar. Okay, rupees $1 is equal to rupee 40. Okay, so how many dollars, how many rupees we have? Rupee 6000 is equal to how much? Okay, so we have to have cross multiply. 6000 divided by 40 will get a 150. Okay, this is the working note. So now I'll write This way we have to calculate 150 we got, then followed by next one 112.5, then again 112.5 followed by 250, total comes to 625 US dollar. And in the same way here 87.50, then 37.50, okay, then 100, then followed by 285.75, seven one, then 171.43. In this case, in case of capital stock, so what we are doing is we are taking in terms of 35, that is $1 is equal to rupee 35. So we have 10,000 rupee is equal to question mark. If you do this one, 10,000 divided by 35, you will get the answer as 285.71. Okay, total, if you do total, what we get is again same thing, 625. We write for something gain or loss, we write here 625. Okay, in the same way, if you go for 1st April, same thing, 42. And here it is all of 42 except capital. Okay. So now again 6000 divided by 42, we'll get 107.14, then 238.10. So totally, if you add all these things, we'll get a 595.74. In the same way, 3500 divided by 42, we'll get 83.33, then followed by 35.71. Then 95.24, then lastly 285.71 and 171.43. retained earnings and capital stock should be mentioned a historical price. Okay, so total as we found 595.24. Okay, this completes basic preparation of your what you call balance sheet. Now we'll find out the accounting exposures. We should find out, so two things. One is 31st March and 1st April. Okay, so exposed assets in 31st March is basically what are things we just got exposed. All the assets, you can see all the assets got exposed. There is all the assets we had taken a current rate method. So total exposed assets is 625. In the same way there 595.74. Okay. In the same way, exposed liability. Exposed liability will get. So exposed liability. So you can see three items is there in the current rate method, and these two in a historic method. These two are in historic method, and these two are current rate method. Current rate. Okay. So we should consider only these three. If you consider these three, The answer what we get is exposed liability 225. In case of second one, it is 499.99. That is, I can say 500. Okay. If you want to consider net exposed, net exposed, net exposed is 400, and in other case it is 95.24. So then CTA, cumulative transaction adjustment, is basically change in exchange rate, change exchange rate multiplied by net exposed. Okay, so if you do this one, change in formula to calculate change in exchange rate is change exchange rate is equal to current exchange rate minus previous exchange rate divided by